Buongiorno!
Good morning! From Modessa Island. So it's an early morning and we've done our morning walk around the island. And
for the last time here in Modessa.
Yes, because in a few hours we will be checking out. And we're back here in our little corner in paradise. This is the place where there are two benches, this one and the other one at the back,
where you can catch see the sunrise.
Yes,
every
the sunrise, and then the sandbar on this side, and you can also hear the birds, see the birds flying around, and just get the morning sun.
And last night was really high tide, and this morning is really low tide. So
yes.
Now we fly the drone. And after we swim, and for the last time, we do breakfast, and after we'll meet to check out.
Yes.
And we will go in a beautiful place. We are really excited, like every time. And
we have another destination to go to.
We have a new destination, so let's go.
Breakfast, and again, Jerick is here.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
There's your fruits.
Yes, the fruits, fresh fruits. Every time we're here, we have banana, pineapple, and watermelon.
And pineapple
papaya.
Juice.
Wow! And
thank
this is
you.
It's fresh. It's fresh.
Fresh juice.
Fresh pineapple juice. And yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you, Jerick.
And the view here is amazing.
Yes, yeah, so now we're having breakfast with this view. And after we swim again a bit, and around 1 p.m. we will go in Port Barton.
Yeah, we are so sad to leave this island, but later on we have to travel to Port Barton. I'm here at the viewing deck of the resort. It's three floors, so you have a bit of a climb going here, and it's fantastic. Look, so right now we are in the restaurant and we're just waiting for our boat before we go to Roxas, and in a few minutes we will be leaving. Of course, Mirco is just doing some stuff in the laptop, and then these are the guys who's been very helpful to us during our stay here.
Hi.
Say hi. Yeah, they fed us very well. We are always full here, the food is good, and of course the beach is amazing. It's paradise. We love Modessa Island.
So we are leaving Modessa and we are going to Roxas.
Bye bye.
Bye
bye. Bye
bye. So we are now in the port of Roxas, and we are going to take the van for going to
Port Barton.
So guys, we are now in San Jose because
we missed the van from Roxas going to Port Barton.
So we take one tricycle for come here in San Jose.
Well, apparently there's only one schedule for the van from Roxas to Port Barton, and it's only once a day. So as an option, we took the tricycle to San Jose.
150 pesos.
And thank God also for Lizelle of Explore Islands Palawan.
That always help us. Yes, it's really helpful, Lizelle.
Yeah,
really,
a van,
thank you.
Yes, a van from Puerto Princessa will pick us up here in San Jose to take us to Port Barton.
So let's drink and wait. It started also to rain. So after waiting 2 hours in the station in San Jose, we didn't find a van. So now we are going to Port Barton with a tricycle.
Let's go!
Yay! So the road is a bit dusty, so it's bumping.
And you're like dancing back and
yes.
forth.
Yes.
There's cemented, there's rocky, cemented, bumping.
So it's a really cool way to go to Port Barton. Yes. Alternative way with a tricycle. 500 pesos.
Fresh air.
Fresh air.
Yes. We are in the middle of our rice fields. And this is our manong. Hermano, he will take us to Port Barton. Anong name niyo, kuya?
Albert Banto.
Albert. Yeah, pag kailangan niyo ng tricycle pa Port Barton, Manong Albert. Anong lugar to, kuya?
Matalangaw.
Matalangaw.
So guys, if you want a different way to travel, this is the perfect way.
Take the tricycle. Plus,
take the tricycle.
You can stop and enjoy the view. If you're in the van,
yes,
you're with other tourists, you can
These
stop.
Are really cool positive things, no? You can do whatever you want. So now we fly. Mm-hmm. So let's go.
Still flying the drone, and we have some amazing shots of the rice fields here, and it's so peaceful, it's so beautiful,
and the drone is on top of us, right?
It's right on top of us.
So you need to know that for going to Port Barton, the road is really muddy and really bumpy. Even if you take a van, car, the road is like this. You need to know that Port Barton is still a small village and rural, so is not already developed like Puerto Princessa or even El Nido. But it's really a beautiful place where to stay because it's a sanctuary for the coral, for turtles. It's really a beautiful place for sea nature. So we need to take all with the positive wave, right? So now this is what happened. We was on our way and we find one tricycle with a problem. And
she's part of that tricycle.
She's part of the tricycle.
Yeah, they had a problem with the wheel.
Yes, we found one tricycle with a problem to the wheel.
But it's good news, their tricycle is now okay.
So we can continue our trip.
Bye-bye, little girl.
We will never be rich Port Barton, we don't know. Let's try.
We will reach it. Bye-bye.
So after we don't know how many hours of travel, we made it. We are now in Puerto Barton.
We're alive.
In a nice place. The room is quite big.
It's like bungalows.
Yeah, it's like bungalow. Yeah. It's chill. Nice. It's nice. And again, the road are really bumpy. The road are really...
It's muddy. It's rocky. It's quite an adventure going here.
Yes.
And we are starving. Mm-hmm. And then we will be checking out the restaurants we just saw.
We see Gorgonzola Pizzeria, and for sure we will go tonight there because we really need to eat. Because we
didn't
eat much. Yes.
So we just had some
tonight we will we'll eat for sure properly, and let's go.
See you tomorrow. No, we will take you to dinner.
So now we are walking on the street here in Port Barton, and. You can see that it's a really rural place. It's really rural. Yeah. All houses are really like cottages, like bungalow. But it's really nice. It's Filipino vibe.
You can smell the ilang-ilang flowers because there's an ilang-ilang, big ilang-ilang tree with,
yes,
with flowers.
And now we are trying to go to see the beach, the sea. And because the color are really nice, actually, and we try to catch
the sunset.
Actually, it's not really a sunset, but we try to catch what is left of the sunset. We finished dinner and we are back in our room. We eat in a restaurant that is called Gorgonzola Pizzeria, and the pizza was good.
It was big.
Yeah, it was really big. It's really big. And now we are here in the terrace of our room and we are watching the moon because tonight is
the super blue blood moon.
And there is a rare event that happens every 150 years. So we are watching it because, of course, it's really beautiful, and right now the moon is all covered, so it's almost all covered. Just a few minutes probably and will be full cover, and after that we will go to sleep because tomorrow we'll have a private tour, and we are hopeful to see beautiful turtles, if you are really lucky dugong, and for sure we'll see beautiful fish. Buonanotte.
Good night.